Hello, welcome back to Art of Pop Culture, and today we're going over the new album from Bastille called Doomsday. And this album is a little different than the last album. And this is pretty much talking about three things. So one of them is the umbrella topic is escapism. The undertone topic is what's going on with the political environment that's happening now. And the general idea of this, the action-wise idea of what's going on in this album is pretty much going off of each song. It's talking about the night, going out that night, and all the way to the morning. So it's kind of exciting. I love a good storyline. I love albums that actually have that continue a ongoing story throughout the whole thing. I think it's so fun. So they do a really good job of doing this with this. So I'm going to break down each song and what I've learned from the background of it. And we'll start right now. So number one is Quarter Past Midnight. This one is pretty much talking about going out. It's the beginning of it. The night starts off at midnight, and it's quarter past midnight. So it's like 5:20 or 12:25. So we're out. We're partying. We're having a good time. My thought is that they're already been partying at a club or something like that. So they're having a good time. They're doing, and he wants to catch that feeling of excitement of having, of doing more, of going out and everything, which I think is really cool. And they definitely laid it down. I love how the pace picks up, the quick pace in the production happens in it. And then there's like a slow breakdown in the middle of it, which is kind of fun. But I love the capture at the beginning of the night. Number two is Decisions, and this one takes place, we're now in 12:48 a.m., and this is now going into more of explaining that, like, there's a bad decision that we do, even though we know it's bad, but we still do it anyway, kind of thing. And it's Slash talking about how, like, a relationship, that's another thing, it's another undertone talk about this, is that there's a relation, it's also talk, like, hinting that there's a relationship going on too, but I really want to more focus on the narrative that it's a party more than anything else, so I'll go off of that. I love the clapping in the pre-chorus. I also love the falsetto of right here in that little middle part. I think it's in the bridge. But yeah, I like this song. And then number three is The Waves. So this takes place in 1:22 a.m. And this one's more talking about, I think right now what we're doing is that, because there's a moment where we actually move on into like a house party. So I think they go from like, we're at the club, we're having a good time, let's keep it going and bring it back to somebody's house. So I think we're now at the house. This one is actually him kind of stepping back and watching the party go on, and he's in and out of lucidity, and he's like, so it's, and I think that's the reason why it's called the waves because it's just like, it's, and which is, I totally can relate to, like, that, and I think we all can, like, when you start really getting intoxicated and you just have this weird, like, wave in and out of conscious, you know, I think it's kind of interesting that he did take that in. Number four is Divided. So, and this one takes place in 2:05. And now this is the part where people, which is so right, because this is the part where people start kind of like, okay, it's time to leave. It's 2:05. It's late. It's the time that the bar closes anyway. So we should just go. And they're like, no, it's not. Why leave? Why leave now? Let's just have a good time. And so, let's take that back. I wonder if, No, I still want to leave it with this. I think I like this narrative that we're at the house party now. But he's pretty much talking about how, like, there's people, like, he doesn't want this party to end. He wants to try to find a way to have it keep going, you know? And I love the piano inside of it too. And then we move on to number five, which is Million Pieces. So, this takes place in 2:39 a.m. This part is actually kind of trying to, this is, this is, more of it. Actually, what's funny is that this is, they quoted that they wanted to have more of an EDM sound and they haven't done before, so they want to try it out. It's experimental, but it definitely sounds great. I love the sound. It's much way dancing than the other songs that happened, but I definitely like it. And so this one is actually talking about how the struggle of not being distracted by the problems that's going on in the world. By the way, it's not really much of an EDM sound, more of like a 90s EDM sound kind of sound. And so he pretty much talks about that. He's like, it's pretty much now he's at the party and things are starting to, people, like, he talks about how somebody like cornered him and wanted to talk about politics. And so he's like, I don't want to talk about this, but now it's in his head, you know? So he's like, oh God, like this is the last thing I want to talk about right now when I'm trying to like get loose and have fun. Number six is Doomsday, which is one of the singles that happened. And I think that this is a reason when it goes into where you start talking about where now that somebody talked about politics, now he's like, oh, well now it's in my head now. Like now that he walked away, it's all I'm thinking of now. And so, and apparently he did 50 verses with this, because he definitely had a lot to say. This is pretty much trying to, this song is pretty much trying to find escapism inside from the modern anxieties that's going on. And so, and he's like, and one parts of the songs I like is, we'll stay offline so no one gets hurt. So I like that. It's just like, so no one, like, because everybody has their opinions right now. Everybody's very opinionated. And so you're going to see a lot of people say stuff and then it's going to, somebody else has something else to say. Or you might get bullies that come and say something to you that really hurts your feelings, you know? And I love the whole stay naive. We're going to Peter Pan out. And I like that kind of like, moving to like Neverland, we're just like that movie is pretty much talking about escapism too, which is like you move away from growing up, you start getting that reality check, and I think that's what he's trying to do. He's like, I want to try to push my way of not thinking of this. Number seven is Nocturnal Creatures, which is a triumph of like, I finally made it out, like I'm not thinking about it anymore. We're building back up to, like, okay, we're back into the party. So this one is, pretty much interesting. There's a spoken sample from Russian Igor. I'm gonna kill this fucking, this is gonna be damaged, but Grigorgov. So pretty much he's talking, this quote at the very, very end, the sample at the very, very end, it's pretty much talks about the rave, like, culture that came into Russia, and this guy is saying, it came into Russia after the whole collapse of the Soviet Union, but because it came in, and the Russians are so used to having, like, very controlled environment, so now they see this, and it's like, okay, like, this is, we're getting to know what it's like in the modern world, and the first world kind of thing, and just like the first world, and like the modern world, and it's just like we're taking all this in, and we just don't know what to do with this freedom, you know? And that's exactly what he's talking about. He's like feeling free, but not really knowing what to do with it, you know? So then number eight is 4 a.m., and obviously this takes place in 4 a.m. By the way, I don't know, like, house parties, I used to do house parties all the fucking time, and I pretty much pass out around 4. 4 is, like, the limit. I usually kind of pass around, like, 2, and it's like that, because it just gets kind of late for me, but I've had times where, like, my roommates would party for, like, a long, long, long time, or the party would go on for, like, a long time, till the a.m., and let's just say that this is pretty much just the same thing. So we're at 4 a.m. where I'm already passed out, but he's still going. So 4 a.m. is pretty much saying, like, he's now in the party where everything's coming down. People are finally kind of crashing or leaving, and it's okay for him. But he's like laying in this pile, and it's like, I really just love this calm down of everybody just kind of laying together. And we're just so we're intoxicated, but we're like tired at the same time, but we're in this weird, like, heavenly, like, woozy bliss. And I love that kind of thing that's going on, because there's a bit of like woozy notes in the beginning that gives you that starts you off with it. And I also love, it's very dreamy, and I love the, I love the, it, like, it kind of comes off with like a piano ballad in a way, but not really. Number nine is Another Places. So this part actually happens at 4:52. So we're pretty much, the sun is starting to rise in some way. I think so. It depends. Global warming. It might be anything else. So in this type of world, we're now in a place where he is talking about a one night stand. And in this kind of world, he's not really sure if this one night stand that they're doing, or just have, like, I guess they must have moved from being in bliss into like, well, now I'm a little horny, so I move, let's go into another place and like, start, you know. And so in this part, they're done having sex and they're just laying there, and he's like, I don't know if this is a thing, if we're actually a thing or not. But it seems like he wants a thing. He does want a thing in general. And this one's more of an upper tempo sound, but he wants a thing, he just don't know when, you know, he's just not sure if this thing is going to be it or is it temporary. Number 10 is Those Nights, which is one of my favorite songs. This happens at 5:56 or 46 a.m. So the party's completely over, officially over, and he talks about wanting to, like, I think it goes in more elaborate about, like, more in detail about this. It's like, he has found somebody to go home with, but he's not really sure if this is temporary, if it's more. It's like he's going more details, and he kind of talks about, like, this type of feeling that's going on. And he's like, okay, I really feel this, and I don't really know what's going on, but it really makes me realize I should definitely want this type of feeling. And finally, number 11 is Joy, which is one of my favorite songs off the album too. And this is the morning after, so the party's done, it's morning, and apparently, like, he says like he's waking up from on the kitchen floor, so he must have moved after the whole thing. And this one's the only upbeat one, like, actually upbeat one. And so this song is pretty much about him, like, kind of feeling down from the night, because he realizes, like, okay, I'm looking for something more permanent with a person, but I do not have that at all. And so he's kind of depressed, but apparently he gets a phone call from one of his really good friends, or some special person that makes him feel good, and it does make him feel better. And the things, one lyric I really love is, how'd you always know that I'm down? And I like that. It's kind of like, it seems like his best friend, or maybe his family member, or something that some close person, like, called him up in conveniently at the time that he was feeling down. And he's like, wow, you really cheered me up. I like this phone call, is all I needed to, like, bring me back into reality, so I'm ready to face the world again, kind of thing. So I really, really love that. It's a really happy ending, and I love it. I actually was curious to see how Joy is going to come in. Definitely after Doomsday was, like, I want to say that was the first single, and then Joy came after, and I was like, oh, well, where is this going to fit? And it fits so perfectly. I definitely give this album, like, I'm a little bit biased because I love a good, I'm sucker for a good storyline inside of album. So I'll give it a 9 out of 10. Like a 8.5 or 8.5 or 9 out of 10. It's just a really, really good album. It's really, really fun. And I love the story, and I love that, like, it talks about the stuff that really going on right now. So, yeah, so that's it. Leave a comment below. Tell me what you thought about the album. My favorite before was Wild World, so I was very excited to see what else they're going to do with it. So I hope everybody has a great week. It's Wednesday, happy hump day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.